Shepherd of our souls,
Savior of our soul, Lover of our soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcome us, for the Lord God is on our side. We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We overcome us, for the Lord God is on our side.
King of all kings, Lord of all lords, we thank you for yet another day you have allowed us to see. Thank you so much for your mercy. Thank you so much for your love. Thanks so much for your care. Lord, we, your little children, have come to hear from you, because your word is life. The word is all we need to live the life you've given us, O God. Jesus Christ, I ask, O God, you speak to me and speak to me to the end, that we all shall be blessed, O God, and become who you desire us to be. Lord, it's your desire that we all should come to you in heaven on the last day. Please, we ask, O God, that word will make us, O God, to come to you, not with nakedness, but well-dressed. Speak that word to us this morning in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, my Father, because I know you do it to your glory alone, in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
I have a message before us this morning from the throne of mercy, which is a quick reminder of what some of us already know. And if there's anybody that does that have not known it, thank God for your life also that you are here this morning. Message is titled, Has the flesh surrendered to your spirit? It's a question this morning. Has your flesh surrendered to your spirit? Knowing that the flesh and the spirit are fighting every day to make sure that one brings one down, which of these two are you working with? Or which of these two is working in you? Until my flesh and your flesh surrender to the spirit, whatever we are doing, we are just wasting our time. If the flesh is still ruling in my life, in your life, it means there's still a long way to go. If the rapture should take place now, flesh will not be able to see you through to where you'll be aiming to go. But then it is written in Galatians chapter number 5, from verse 13. Galatians 5, 13. It said, for brethren, ye have been called unto liberty. Only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh. I come again. For brethren, ye have been called unto liberty. Only use not liberty for occasion unto the flesh, but by law serve ye one another. Verse 14. For all the law is fulfilled in one word, even in this, thou shalt love thy neighbor and thyself. Verse 15. But if you bite and devour one another, take heed that ye be not consumed one of another. Why will all this happen? If we are still living in the flesh, if we are still working in the flesh, there's no way we will not devour one another. There's no way envy, jealousy, all those things will not play out. There's no way hatred will not play out. Verse 16. This I say then, for you and I not to devour each other, for you and I to be able to live in joy, in peace. This I say then, walk in the spirit. Let your flesh surrender. That flesh that's making you an eye to get jealous over nothing, to be envious over nothing, to backbite, to gossip. Flesh is the power behind those things. For you and I not to do those things, we must walk in the spirit. The flesh must die. For this I say, walk in the spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Your flesh will not ruin you. Your flesh will not ruin you. Your flesh will not tell you, don't you see that that person is better than you? Don't you see the way that sister is doing, the way she's praying, is praying to let you know that you cannot? Don't you see that brother is challenging you? It's flesh that makes us to face challenges. Verse 17. For the flesh lusted against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary one to another. Then, which are you with now? If flesh and spirit is contrary one to the other, which one in among them now are you operating on? Is it the flesh or the spirit? Verse 17 again. For the flesh lusted against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary to one another, so that you cannot do those things which you would. The reason we cannot do those things we would have done is because we have allowed the flesh to win the battle. If the spirit is winning, we'll be able to pray the way we should pray. We'll be able to love the way we should love. We'll be able to serve God the way we should serve Him. But because we have allowed the flesh to dominate, because the dominating one is the flesh, that's why we are not able to do what we are supposed to do. That's why we still envy each other. We still hate each other. We still murmur against each other. We still think evil against each other because flesh is still at work. That's why Christ told us, the only reason why you and I can only understand the word of God and to live by the word of God is when the spirit is in charge. Because the word of God is spirit. God is spirit. For you and I to be able to serve Him effectively, be productive, we must be in spirit. That's what He told us in John chapter 6, verse 63. It is the spirit that quickeneth. It is the spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profit nothing. The flesh we have allowed to rule. The flesh we are supporting. This load we are supporting. So it profit nothing. It will only ruin you and I. Don't you know I am? It will only ruin you and I. Do you know who I am? It will only ruin you. It's this flesh that wants to be known. He that said, it is the spirit that quickeneth, but the flesh profit nothing. The word that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. And how can we understand if we are not in the spirit? There's no way we will not get angry over the word that will deliver your eye if we are still in the flesh. There's no way we will not devour each other if we are still in the flesh. When we start understanding the word of the Lord, we'll start living for the Lord effectively. And the flesh must die for this to come to pass. Has my flesh died? Has my flesh surrendered to my spirit? I have to say myself, what are those things I'm still struggling with? Am I still struggling when the rapture is already here? Am I still struggling to pray when the rapture, when the Lord is already here now? It means I have to do something about the power of the flesh. I used to struggle with one thing or the other, one sin at all. It means flesh is still dominating. We have to do something very fast about it before it is too late. Galatians chapter 6, verse 8. He that soweth to the flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. He that allow the flesh to rule him or her shall by the flesh see himself in destruction on the last day. If we are still being controlled to gossip, to backbite, to envy, to jealous, to speak the way we are not supposed to speak. Hey, corruption is imminent. Remember what the Bible told us in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter number 15, from 52 down. Say, in a twinkle of an eye, many shall be many that will be translated, that they will be translated into corruption. If the flesh is still ruling, he that sweat to the flesh shall by the flesh be corruption, or he that sweat to the spirit, he that live righteously, holily, shall by the spirit reap everlasting life eternal. Rapture is not possible when we are still living for the flesh. Dying and making heaven is not possible when we are still living in sin. We must be able to overcome sin. Making heaven is not by chance. It's the life we live now that will guarantee you and I to make heaven. The gates of heaven will only be open for those who are in spirit, perfectly in spirit. That's why I must do something about myself. You must do something about yourself. If the fire of yesterday is not enough, kindle today's own now. If the holiness of yesterday, you know yourself, I know myself. If we know the holiness of yesterday, we will not be able to take us to heaven. Let us do something very fast now before it is too late. Because as we are talking right now, so many people who have planned for today have gone. They have gone. They cannot pray anymore. And if you and I were also dead yesterday, mercy have expired. That's why we must do something about our life. Romans chapter 8, verse 1 down. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, not just those who are in Christ Jesus alone, not just be born again and become like him. Because the Bible told us in the book of John 4:24, for God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him. He never said they should, say they must worship him in spirit and in truth. So therefore, Romans 8:1 says, therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus. He never stopped there. Who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. Do we still get angry easily? Oh God, Father, help us. Do we still do those things that we say we will not do again? Father, help us. Verse 2 of Romans chapter 8. For the law of the spirit of life in Christ has made me free from the law of sin and death. Verse 3. For what the law could not do, in that it was weak to the flesh, God sent his son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin condemned sin in the flesh. Verse 4. That the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit, who the things of this world cannot cajole anymore. You cannot see the seeker and say, hey, I must. This house, oh, I must get it. Until the things of this world can no longer control us anymore, it's the problem. Hey, my friend, I've done this. Oh God, that is not your prayer. You have forgotten heaven now. Oh, this house, oh, this car, oh, this, oh. Until we are not be pushed to do those things that the people of the world does, I think something is the problem. Until we cannot say, Lord, it's all about you. Until we not get to the level, if I perish, I perish. That's the problem. Verse 5. For they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh. What things are we minding now? For those that are after the flesh mind the things of the flesh. But they that are after heaven, I paraphrase, after the spirit, the things of the spirit. The things of heaven, they are all spiritual. Totally spiritual. According to Colossians chapter 1, chapter 3, verse 1 to 4. If we say we are born again, if we say we are planning for rapture, let us live out as though, as if we are set for the rapture. Let us live as though we know that all these things cannot go, we'll unpack them on that day. Let us close our eyes and gaze at this of this world and live for the spirit. Verse 6. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Can't you see? Carnality has to go. Carnality must surrender to spirituality. Worldliness must surrender to holiness totally. Verse 7. Because the carnal mind is enmity against God. How are you now? Who is our enemy to God? We want to be raptured that day. The Lord is not coming for his enemy. He's coming for his friends, those who worship him in spirit and in truth. To be carnally minded is because to the carnal mind is an enemy against God. For it is not subject to the law of God. Neither is it can be. The reason why we cannot serve God fluently, the reason why we are still galloping, is because we are still carrying the things of the flesh. We are still minding the things that the people of the world are minding. For you and I to be qualified to vanish away on that day, or to sleep and see our soul get up and the gate of heaven open, we must totally let the flesh go. Lord, help me and help you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Verse 8. So then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. Are you still walking in the flesh? No matter the preacher you are preaching, man. No matter the singer you are singing. No matter the prayer you are praying. The Lord is nowhere pleased. And if we cannot please him, there's a problem. Father, please help me here. I beg you. I need your grace, O God. Verse 9. But ye are not in the flesh. Is it true? Are you not seeing the flesh? But in the spirit, if so be that the spirit of God dwelleth in you. Now, if any man have not the spirit of Christ, he is not of his. Verse 10. And if Christ be in you, the body is dead because of sin, but the spirit is life because of righteousness. But if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus, verse 11, from the dead, dwelleth in you. If that spirit is in you and I, we cannot sin anymore. We cannot say things that we don't need to say anymore. Hatred will be rebuked before it comes. Envy will be rebuked on the way. It will attack it with the sword before it comes. We cannot manifest the things of the flesh again. Why? Because he that raised Christ from the dead, Christ died for sin. Was raised away from sin. Why are we still living in what Christ died for? It means we are still subject to the flesh. Father, help me. He that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by the spirit that dwelt in you. Why are we not being quickened? The spirit of God that dwells in us is a quickening spirit. We are supposed to get the signal. Sin is coming. No, you cannot get to me. I cannot hate Sister Deja. It's not possible. I cannot hate Sister Mercy. It's not possible. I can't do this anymore. I am a rapture. I am a product of the rapture. The gate of heaven must open for me on that day. Why? Because I am no more of this world again. The things of this world cannot fascinate me anymore. I cannot lust over anything of this world. Money or no money, I will be who I am for the Lord. No matter the situation, I will flow with the Lord. No matter this. Until we get to that level, there's still a problem. Verse 12 of Romans 8. Therefore, brethren, we are debtor, not of the flesh, to live after the flesh. For if you live after the flesh, ye shall die. Can't you see? Tabiola, can't you see? He said, if we live after the flesh, we will die. You. So for us not to die, let us quickly convert now. Let us start living for the Spirit. Don't run after what the American people are running after. If the Lord gives it to you, okay, God, thank you. Even if you have it, do as if you don't have them. Because this world can never be your own. It can never be. You will be rejected by the world. Never ever do anything to fall in love with the world again. And no matter how you try, the world will never love you. This flesh will never love you. You know why? Because you have offended the world. The very day you say, Lord, it's you and I. Even if you don't come back again now, they know you will go back again. So they can never love you again. So you must forever live for the Lord. But if you through the Spirit do mortify the deed of the body, ye shall live. Let us mortify our body. Let discipline it. Put a mindset. Lord, this is the life I want to live now. No matter how you yourself try to exalt me, Lord, I will put myself this way. The Bible said the Lord humbled himself. He decided to live for. If you are a spirit, you must be humble. You must always try to put people. Oh, Father, help us here. Lord, help us. Help me in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Don't you see now, we are children of the devil if we are not living by the Spirit? It's not by saying, I am created by God. I am born again. If you are born again, you are not in the Spirit. You are still a son, a daughter of the devil. What distinguishes you from that prostitute, from that arm robber, is you being in spirit. If you are born again and you are not in spirit, you are still like them. All of them are big carnal. If you are also born again, yet you are still carnal, you are like them. There's no difference. Hell is still guaranteed. The Lord will help you and help me in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So let's look. At Galatians chapter 5, verse 19. Are these things still with me? It means I have to, after preaching, have to quickly go and do something about myself. Galatians chapter 5, 13, please, can you read this so that everybody will hear it?
Yes, sir.
Verse 19.
I read in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
The works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, 20, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, 21, envies, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such like, of which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Emmanuel, search there now. You also search there as if there's nothing in you that is still pertaining to that place now. Are you not still having one in there? If we are still having one, he said, don't you know that those who have this thing in them cannot inherit the kingdom of God? So you don't need anybody to tell you that you are already hell. I don't need anybody that to tell that as I'm preaching now, there's a problem somewhere. If I don't quickly go and settle myself now, do we still have all this envy, murder, craftiness, hatred, variance in us? Let's do something now so that all our gathering, even the convention, I want you to come and start preaching. Hey, you are blessed. He said, no, go this way, my son. Go this way. Do we still have all these things in us? If yes, let us do something before it is too late. Because the night is fast spent. Ma, please continue with verse 22.
Verse 22.
But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. 24. And they that are Christ have crucified the flesh with the affections and lust. 25. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. 26. Let us not be desirous of vainglory, provoking one another, envying one another.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want us to check the works of the flesh now and also go to the fruit. You can see, when it comes to the Spirit, it said the fruit of the Spirit, the works of the flesh. Now, I want you and I to check ourselves. Do I have love in me? Do I have joy in me? Is there peace of God in me? Do I bear long suffering? Am I able to tarry in my pain with the Lord? Am I gentle? Not the one, not like serpent, not gentleness and making one. No, not that one. Are you able to surrender? Are you able to let yourself die for other people to live? It's not just quietness, is not gentleness. Gentleness is ability to surrender to the word of the Lord, to surrender to the word of the Lord. Gentleness is to always say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Do we have it in us? Meekness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Do we have them? Are they complete, you and I? If they are not complete, my dear sister Ego, there's a problem. Wherever you are, put your name there, there's a problem. If all these things are not complete, not, if our love have not got it to the level, hey, there's a problem. If the joy of the Lord have not got to that level, that no matter the situation, we are still joyous. Food or no food, there's still joy to serve the Lord. No matter the condition, the joy is still there. But if we are still being controlled by the things of this world, hey, I don't have this, because of this, I cannot, oh, there's a problem. There's a problem. And he said, if we say we are in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit then. If we say we are the children of God who is a Spirit God, let us also walk the way He walks. God is perfect. Why can't you and I also be perfect? The Spirit of God cannot sin. So if we say we are Spirit, let us be Spirit and walk in Spirit. I bless you, Samagwe. No matter the situation, we must be spiritual. My brother, this is our joy. From Cameroon. We must be Spirit. No matter the situation, we must live in the Spirit if we must see the Lord on that day. I said, let us not be desirous of the flesh, of their glory, provoking one another, envy one another. Do we see envy one another? It means hell is still guaranteed you. Let us do everything, see others better than you are. Instead of you to envy others, strive to be what God wants you to be. Don't put yourself in people's shoes. Do it differently. Do it godly. Let the Lord be pleased in everything you are doing. Don't try to be like somebody. God help me, He will help you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And for you and I to be able to do this, we must embrace what Apostle Paul said in Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. I am crucified with Christ. I am dead with Christ. Sister Chi, did you hear that? Nevertheless, I live. Yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. I am not the one living anymore. I can be able to live in any situation because it's no more me. I don't know if Sister Jessica is saying this now. And the life which I now live in the flesh, though I'm still carrying the body, but I'm no more living for the body. I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. I don't longer live to please myself anymore. I don't longer live again to please, to tell my body, yes, no, I'm not living to please him. That died for me. Know why? Because I don't want to frustrate the grace of God upon my life. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Got time. I'll take one, maybe we'll continue for the next time. How do we do this again? We must let the flesh suffer. So let's rejoice. Mark chapter 8, verse 32, verse 33. Sorry, Mark 8, 35. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. How do you save your life? By making this flesh to rejoice. Oh God, I cannot, Father, because of you are trying to make your flesh happy. If you save the flesh, the soul will die. But if you kill the flesh now, the soul will live. Both of them can only live at the same time. It's either the flesh is dead or the soul is dead. If you save your flesh, you lose your soul. If you lose your soul, you save your flesh. But God said to you and I, whosoever shall save his life shall lose it. Whosoever shall lose his life for my sake and for the gospel, the same shall save it. Let us put the flesh where it belongs now. Let's tell the body, I'm not living for you anymore. I'm not living for you anymore. I know you are going down to 6 feet. I want to live to the one that is going up there. So, whatever that will make you to destroy me, I take it away from you now. Go help me.
Amen.
And the Lord Jesus Christ, he labor for you and I. He suffer for you and I will not be vain.
On the Amen.
Life of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Pray. As the Bible told us in John 12:24, except the corn of wheat die, he remains the same. But if he die, it will grow and become what God wants to be. Lord, today, I surrender my flesh for crucifixion. I surrender myself, my flesh, for what? For crucifixion. Crucify it. Help me to destroy this flesh. Lord, if you want to do it by myself, I will never do it. You will come and leave it behind. Jesus, I surrender myself to you. Destroy this flesh. Crucify it and let the spirit start living from today, henceforth. In the name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and pray.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, my Father, my God, Baba, Father, Lord, I beg of you, Baba.
I'm trying to live
in this. God, Baba, I beg of you, Baba, let this flesh, oh God, Baba, in me, Baba, try to live. It's flesh that want to send my soul to the fire. Father, please, oh God,
let's
go.
Between my flesh and my spirit. Lord, take over the battle. If you lead the battle for me, I am doomed. Help me to take over the battle, oh God, in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Open my prayer.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. This is the mountain of solution and redemption prayer ministry worldwide, aka the Shepherd and the Bishop of our Souls Ministry Worldwide.